I have, Sam. Miscellaneous kids memorabilia. Oh, not for now. Tax records. 1961 through 1976. Definitely not for now or ever. Here we go. Christmas decorations. Just 3 boxes. Well, it always seemed like we had so many more of these. These decorations. Just 3 boxes. Let's see. I ain't been in here in quite some time. Oh, what's this? What? It's our old Christmas album. There we are. Me and Rachel. Standing in front of some silly looking backdrop. Now I remember. Rachel had a coupon and we took it at the Walmart. Oh, Rachel, feels sort of funny going through all this stuff without you, honey. You had yourself some mighty fine decorations, didn't you? Mighty fine. I just don't quite know what to do with it all. You were always the one to put up the decorations, and, well, I was the one to always put up the lights. I remember that first Christmas, we had all these red and green Christmas lights. And, well, I must have put 1,000 of those things up all over the trees and the house. And I must have blown out 20 fuses before I finally got it right. Well, I haven't done the lights in 3 years, Rachel. Kids are still coming over, but I haven't done the lights. Just seemed like too much trouble. Oh my, look at that. Well, it's a picture of us on our last Christmas together. Well, this year, Rachel, I'm gonna go over to Maggie's house. And she and Jeff and the kids, they insisted I come over there. They wanna worry over me and fuss over me. And you know what? I think I'll let them. I said, Maggie, I'll just come on over there for the day. And she said, no, Pop, you need to pack a bag and come over for the whole week. I said, Maggie, that's silly. I just live across town. Plus, I've got yard work to do. But Maggie, well, you know, she was just like you, Rachel. Stubborn as a mule. She insisted. The kids are doing good, Rachel. You'd be proud of them. Come over all the time and drive me crazy. I try to get out a lot. I even went on vacation with them last summer to Disney World. You should have seen me on that Space Mountain. Well, I was a real hoop. You would have loved it, Rachel. I sure do miss you, Rachel. I do indeed. I'm doing good. Sometimes, especially this time of year, well, it just doesn't seem like Christmas without you. I just can't ever seem to get started on it.
You're okay, babe.
Christmas.
Call me home.
anybody home? Oh, I wonder where everybody is. Boy. Boy, if somebody could have came to the door to help me carry some of the stuff in. Oh. Hello? Anybody home? Oh, I wonder where. Hello? I'm here, everybody, anybody? Yeah, well, so. I wonder where everybody is. I saw both cars out there in the driveway. Oh, here's both sets of keys on the table. I wonder where everybody
is. Yes, you have any idea where my car keys are?
No, Maggie, I'm not starting any of your car keys.
Jeff, would you please get in here and help me find my keys?
Gosh, I have so much to do today. Okay, so listen to this, Jeffrey. I have to go to the honey baked ham store. I do that. I gotta go to the cleaners. I have to go to Toys R Us for some Mighty Morphin something or other for Sam Jr.'s kids. I have to drop off some cookies at Peggy Green's house. Come on, I gotta find my keys.
You make cookies? You didn't tell me you make cookies.
Because they're not for you.
Oh, well, the last time I seen your car keys was last week when I made a big fuss at you for leaving them on the floor of your car.
Well, I guess I've had them since then, dear.
Mom, promise me you'd take me to the mall this evening. I gotta do my Christmas shopping. Hey, Dad, you got any money?
Oh, I ain't got any money. Your little sister already beat you to it. Oh, which reminds me, hey, stop at the ATM. Give me a little cash. About $80 you gotta do it.
Guys, I am running out of time here. I've got to get the ham.
Come on, Mom. The mall's right all the way to the ham store. Sort of.
Yeah. Sort of. And then I'll sort of get caught in all the traffic on Pleasant Hill Road. And I'll sort of have to stand in line at the ATMs with your dad. And then I'll sort of not get to the ham store before it closes. Not get our ham for Christmas dinner. And if I don't find my car keys, we're sort of not going anywhere.
I'll make you a deal.
Yeah.
I'll give you the key off my ring, if I can find it. You'll stop off and give me some cash.
Yeah, well, I'll make you a deal. You give me your key, and you can eat some of the ham on Christmas Day. Okay, well, you drive this guy to the mall yourself, get your own cash, and then you can circle the parking lot so your heart's content, Jeffrey.
I can't do that, Max. I've got choir rehearsal.
Whoa! Okay, guys. It's not even Christmas and I'm already going crazy, okay? Look at all this stuff I have to do. I have to do Amanda. Have you seen Amanda, your daughter? Someone has to take care of her tonight. Amanda!
Yeah? What's wrong, Mom?
Nothing's wrong in here. Okay, Amanda, here's some choices for you. You can run errands with Mom. You can go to choir rehearsal with your dad. I would not recommend that. Or you can stay home with your big brother. What you really want to do?
Any other choices?
No. Mom, I can't stay home. I have to do some Christmas shopping.
Ah, now I get it. You finally gonna buy your dad that chainsaw. Serious, right, son?
Ay-ay-ay. That reminds me. Have you heard from Dad today?
Yeah, he called this afternoon and said he'd be here about 6.
Well, it's 6:30 now, and he's not here, okay? On your way to rehearsal, stop off and check on him. He's old now. He might have fallen down and he can't get up. Somebody is getting a life alert for Christmas.
Okay, I gotta get my car keys. I gotta go change my clothes.
Stop.
Okay, stop! Everybody stop. Come back here. We're gonna make a plan. Put it on my list. All right, listen. Okay, you listen. You take Tim with you to car rehearsal, okay? Get your own cash. There's an ATM on the way. You guys get your own dinner. Amanda, you come with me. We'll stop at Arby's, get our dinner. Yum. And then we'll go to the ham store, toy store. We'll swing by, pick up your brother from car rehearsal with Dad, take him to the mall. And then you make sure you stop off at Dad's and check on him. You go write Granddad a note, stick it on the front door. Tell him we'll be back later, come on in, get himself settled, make himself at home, blah, 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 blah. Okay, right, ready, come on, hands together.
Mom.
Hands in. Okay. okay, team. We are organized! Break! Yes.
Maybe we should invite everybody in to be a part of it, and we're going to need a Bible. You got a bite, Mandy?
Oh, yeah, Mom and Kate's one over by the coffee table.
Oh, great. Let's move over there then. Tell you what. Why don't you go around everybody? Tell them you found something. Tell them you found the mystery gas tank. And I'll clear a spot here on the table so we can get everything set up. Okay? All right, you ready? Bam! Come in. Slow down, honey. There's no hurry.
Actually, we're just coming in to do the story.
That's right. So, Tim, Why doesn't everybody have a seat? We'll do the story.
That sounds great. Okay, man. Now you're in charge of getting all the pieces set up in the right spot. Take special care of that dog.
Hey, that looks just like Tim.
I think it's the ears. Holy One to be born will be called Son of God. All right. Now, who else wants to read?
I'll read, Dad. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He's Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." So
hold on a minute. This is my favorite part. Can I read this part? So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. And when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Well, that's it. That's the story.
Hey, why don't we sing my favorite Christmas carol?
Oh, that'd be wonderful. Yeah. 10 or 12 miles away from the church building.
Yeah, yeah, brother, you got that right.
Hey, Granddad, where's baby Jesus?
Oh, the baby Jesus. Oh, he must have been in my pocket here with the frankincense.
Well, you know what Mom would say about that.
Yep, the first thing she'd say is, you get any of that wax on my table, I'm going to bust your chops, Buster. And then she'd say, here's the baby Jesus. He was born in a stable, and now he lives in us. So have yourself a merry little Christmas now.